around 629 at B98.7. The inversion building in today will hit 62 degrees. Right now it's 38 downtown Salt Lake City. They were one of the biggest bands of all time, and there's only one surviving brother. It was two twins, an older brother, and their harmonies were unmatched. They went into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame as one of the first bands to be inducted. They had more number one songs in a row than the Beatles and Elvis. And there's a book that just came out about them, as they'll be inducted to the Kennedy Center Honors here in a week. What is that band we're speaking of? Well, we'll talk to the author who wrote a book about them coming up in 10 minutes. As we start off this Thursday morning, in a few weeks, the Kennedy Center Honors. This is a big deal in Washington, D.C. every year, and the Bee Gees are going in. Barry Gibb will be on hand to be honored. Barry's also going into the Songwriter Hall of Fame. And with us, the author of a great book about the Bee Gees, in fact, a series. And Grant Walters, are you there?
I'm here. How are you doing, Frank?
Doing great, Grant. And let's talk Bee Gees here quickly, because this book, Decades, is all about the Bee Gees. Their records, their songs, a lot of great stories, too. And you helped write it with Spencer Gibb, the son of Robin Gibb. He helped on this book.
He sure did. Spencer is a friend of mine. He's been a really invaluable resource for us. Mm-hmm. Great guy. He's an accomplished musician, producer, songwriter. And artists as well. So having his input for both of these books was incredible.
Well, one of the first albums I owned was Saturday Night Fever, and I loved it. And what I loved about the Bee Gees, they're all brothers. They grew up together. There's two twins, Robin and Maurice, and the older brother, Barry. And they have inspired the Bee Gees with their music, a lot of today's pop artists. You look at Bruno Mars, you look at Justin Timberlake, Maroon 5, Dua Lipa, any songs with disco influence, well, they clearly grew up listening to the Bee Gees.
Yeah.
And if somebody who's younger has never heard of the Bee Gees, what would you say to them? How would you describe that band? I mean, you wrote the book about them.
They're such an important band because, I mean, they were prodigious. These were three brothers that didn't have a lot of formal education. They couldn't read or write music. And so their talent was completely and naturally derived. And so they were consummate professionals. They were incredible songwriters, amazing producers. And as you mentioned, the influence that they had was incredible. The music they produced influenced generation upon generation. And I mean, their career lasted for 60 years.
And a lot of people don't know this, but they had more number ones in a row than the Beatles or Elvis. And that record was only broken by Michael Jackson's Thriller album.
Yeah.
When I think of harmonies, there's none better than the Bee Gees. It's like honey coming out of the speakers. And did they discover those harmonies, them being brothers, the brothers Gibb, at a young age?
There's some ambiguity about who exactly figured it out, but, you know, the story goes is that either their mom or their dad, when they were living on Keppel Road in Manchester, you know, the Barry and the twins were sitting on their beds in their bedroom, and they lived in a really modest house, and you know, they walked in one day and heard them singing in perfect harmony. Their dad was a big band leader, so yeah, it was all derived from the influences around their course. As they started making music, they were influenced by the Beatles, like everybody else was at the start of the 60s, and so it was really organic.
And I'm not sure if we'll ever see another band like the Bee Gees and their unparalleled harmonies, and this book chronicles it. Decades, the 70s, the Bee Gees. It's available wherever books are sold. It's the second book in the series. The 80s will come out next year. And one of the authors, Grant Walters, with us. Grant, appreciate you talking Bee Gees this morning.
Thanks for having me, Frank. Take care.
It's 6:44. Well, you can't tell.
KOTB B98.7 with your tickets to the New Kids on the Block coming to USANA next summer. You got the right stuff. Now get the tickets. Listen and win every day this week at 8, noon, and 4 on NKOTB 98.7.